G'day travellers, here we are on the episode that we didn't think was going to happen. We are Mundi Mundi Bash, but first tonight we're going to pull up and spend the night at the Herman Ale Pub, where we're going to catch up with Jackie B and a few of the members of Country Pub Camping for a bit of a catch up and a few cold ones, and then into Broken Hill tomorrow morning, grab our tickets, and then out to Mundiville. We're going to spend the next 4 days with the Duck and Mrs. Duck, sitting back and listening to some good Aussie rock and roll. So,
and a little bit of country.
And a little bit of country. And a lot of bloody rock and roll. We'll catch you at the Herman Ale. Just arrived in Hermandale and going in the pub now to find out where we set up the camper for the night, and then I reckon it's time for a cold one. It's been a big day in the car. Set up in the nick of times. The heavens are just starting to open, so I'm going to hop inside and then we're going to go in the pub, I think. Well, just after six, we had a cracking night at the Herman Ale. Sorry for the lack of footage. We were a bit hungry and a bit thirsty, so we just got in there at eight and drunk. But we've just had brekkie, so they open at 5 a.m. for brekkie. And I tell you what, really good food, both dinner and brekkie. Top notch. So if you're heading through on the way to Broken Hill, then you're going through a little place called Herman Ale, pull in here. You see behind me, there is a stack of caravans. So they have overnight camping. As long as you're self-contained, it is free, and top-notch little pub, really nice people, and we caught up with all the crew from Country Pub Camping, and that's Jackie B's rig right behind me. We're going to pack up the camper now and hit the road, because we've got about 6 hours to Broken Hill. Check in at the race course, get our tickets, then out to the bash. We'll see you there. Broken Hill bound, just went through Cobar and thought, you know, we'll pull up at the Cobar sign and get a cracking shot for the thumbnail of this video. It was absolutely chock-a-block of caravans and semi-trailers. So I guess, we love outback travel, but when there's a big festival like the Mundi Mundi Bash, it's a bit crowded out here, isn't it?
Definitely is.
Anyway, talking to crowds, I reckon we're in for a bit of a crowd at the showgrounds when we go to pick up the tickets, and hopefully the overflow from yesterday is finished, because they had a big downpour out at Silverton yesterday, and the Silverton Road was closed, so everyone with the 2 day early pass was stuck in Broken Hill. So I'm hoping all that shenanigans is cleared, and we have an easy run in. Hopefully we get through there in some good time, because I wouldn't mind pulling up at the Silverton pub for a coldie before we hit Mundiville. About 250 k's and about 2.5 hours travel time, but that's BQ, about a K out from the race course, and we're just slowly puttering down the road, so I don't know how long this is going to take. Might take a little while, I think.
Yeah, I think it might.
Anyway, we'll see you at the other end. Bit of a lineup, but we're in. Let's go get these wristbands and get out to Mundi. Morning travellers, first day at the Bash, day one. And I tell you what, you never know where your bloody neighbours are gonna be. This way.
He went that away and I'm gonna go this away.
That's it.
The Mundi Mundi Bash is open. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
That's
that
wonderful.
Great.
Thank Let's
you.
Have this side of the audience. In a second, when the cameraman's out of the way, careful. Child, you lost time.
good is this? The end of day one of the Mundi Mundi Bash. Look at that sunset just finishing out the back of our kitchen, about to throw some lamb on the barbie, and we have got Russell Morris playing in the background. Living the dream. Well, day two of the Mundi Mundi Bash, and things kick off a little bit later today. Got the chopper flying in the background. Had some brekkie in this amazing backdrop of the barrier rain just behind me. And Mundi Mundi Plains are just out of the town of Silverton. And Silverton was called Silverton because it was a silver town. It was based on silver mining. And you walk around here and all over the ground is just silver. It's I could only imagine how much of this stuff was around before they... just have a look. This is just around our campsite. Picked up off the ground. Absolutely everywhere.
Yeah.
travellers. The end of day two at the Mundi Mundi Bash. Done and dusted, and I'm sitting around the campfire having a few drinks with a duck. And Greg Donovan, the man behind the Big Red Bash and the Mundi Bash. Greg, bloody awesome event, mate.
Been alright.
So we got another one happening in August, I believe.
Yep.
Punters, if you want to get out of here, still tickets on sale for the Mundi Mundi Bash in August. What about the Big Red Bash in July?
All sold out.
So you need to get out into the Mundi Mundi Bash in August because this is a bloody awesome event.
We've got Barnsley in August.
Look at that.
Hey.
Listen, if you're doing nothing in August, get yourself out here. This is going to be one of the best events that's ever happened in New South Wales. In fact, I'm going to call it
Australia. Australia.
Can't say Australia,
because
the Big Red Bash is
quite
the
name.
True.
So, we're doing a double act here.
Yep.
Yeah.
Whatever it is, it's bloody good. You need to get yourself out of here to Bragg and Hill and to the Mundi Mundi Bash.
And we could also, we're just reminiscing now, Russell Morris has been playing.
He's put on a cracking show, and we're just reliving that memory. We love it. Mate, we're living the dream.
Rob's living the dream.
Yeah.
You know what? Rob went that away. We wish he went that away, don't we, Rob?
Yeah, we went that away. Well, good morning, folks. Day three of the Mundi Bash, and big night, and somehow this thing's empty. What do you do, dude?
What did you do, Rob?
Bad influence of the neighbours, I think. Anyway, we're going to get some brekkie going, and big day today. We've got John Williamson and Paul Kelly. Right, how good's this, folks? Just hanging by the main arena on day three of the Mundi Bash, and going to make history with a world record attempt for the nut bush. How good is it, folks? Last day of the Mundi Bash, and I tell you what, we had a pretty big night last night around the campfire with this bloke.
We are very dusty today, and not because of the dust either.
And Greg Donovan, and
you're a bad man, Rob.
Mate,
Barney.
There was a hole in that bottle of bourbon, I think, Duck.
Yes, there certainly was. But we're enjoying the last day here, Rob. How good is it? We love it.
Oh, mate,
get over there and get amongst the action. And I think the nut bush this morning was great.
Oh, mate, it was fantastic.
Fantastic. It's the best thing I've seen since the undie run. And I was going to go in the undie run, and it wasn't because of the undies. I didn't go in it. I just couldn't be bothered doing the run, Rob.
That's it. That's it, mate. And a big day today. We've got Paul Kelly, John Winston, Shane Howard.
Yeah, it's going to be a fantastic day. The weather's good. The wind's dropped, and we're into it.
I reckon these guys need to get out to the one in August. What do you reckon?
Yeah, absolutely. Get out there. Get out here. It's great. We love it. People lose, people try, hurt, people cry, people live, people die, people lie, ha ha ha, yes they lie, they lie.
now, guys. Only two acts left. John Williamson and Paul Kelly. And the sun is setting over the Mundi Plains. This place is unbelievable.
The beer's rare as a Kwantong tree. Grandma makes some jam for my brothers and me. They're like the Mallee fowl you hardly ever see. I don't mind at all if you call me a Mallee boy. By yourselves this morning. That was bloody terrible. We're ancient mountains, or we're dulled down millions of years to a little mound, where giant feet are fossil found. I see spin effects surfing on a dune. The rock is redder in the afternoon. Tourists licking madly, sir. Where spring will come with any rain, a chance to flower and sing again. Forever garden, rise and plain, the dangers of the wild remain.
All happening now, folks. John Williamson just finished and it is pelting down rain. We're going to get down to see Paul Kelly? Don't know. We're going to get out of here in the morning? Don't know. Stay tuned.
Your antique king's cross is 13 hours on a bike. I press my face against the glass. Watch the white lines rushing by. All around me felt like all inside. Never had no money. Then when you get laid off, they really hit the skids. He started up his drinking, then they started fighting. He took it pretty badly, well, she took both the kids. She said, I'm not standing by to watch you slowly die. So watch me walking out of the door, out of the door, out of the door.
That's it, folks. Our first and the first Mundi Mundi Bash is done and dusted. 4 days of dirt, wind, rock and roll, and even a little bit of rain. But we had an awesome time, and it won't be the last time we'll be at one of these events. So now we're about to hit the road, heading to the beautiful Trilby Station on the Darling River. And you know how it goes. If you like what we do, smash that subscribe button, and we will catch you all on the Darling River on the next episode of We Went That Away Adventures. Cheers, guys.
Bye.